Hello and welcome to the Warehouse Studio, where we get close, candid and casual with some of our very own Goan celebrities. I'm Aurvile and this is Dazzling Silvia.
And we have the Warehouse Band, Frazer, Marlon, Edelbert and Mr. BOBO. Well, the song that we're going to do for you today is called My Fair Lady, sung by Lorna and SEBY. Lyrics by Lawrence de Tiracol and music composed by Ronnie Montserrat. Let's go for it.
Azar za tot garam boso Lady moji zali gori
Silvi se che kalle tu ka khup me wok suk kis rati kau ja chakuti
so pyacher tu boson kaun bol fugle dol o beti now you are so fatty
act now. She's performed on national television and today she's here at the Warehouse Studio.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting Super Mom!
Do you wanna dance?
Mind-blowing performance. This charming and vivacious lady is a Zumba instructor, conducts wellness programs, represented Goa for several international as well as national dance festivals, worked in the aviation industry for a while. She also has the title of the runner-up for the Dance India Dance Super Mom on ZTV. Acting, dancing, singing, entrepreneurship, politics, you name it, she's done it all.
And we also have with us this gentleman with a strong passion for music and cinematography. He's done films like Vengeance and Crossroads. He's also been an editing supervisor for the film Unexpected, which was screened at the International Film Festival of India. He also has a Konkani music album called Visotsona. A man of many talents who is also a chef by profession. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Cecille Rodrigues and Khabir Moraes. Looking gorgeous, as always.
In fact, you both are looking like rockers. You are looking exactly like James Hetfield.
Metallica. I met them in person.
Wow. Yeah.
In fact, I was cooking for the drummer, Lars.
Wow. Wow. Now that's something.
You're making me jealous.
So you've met him personally and like you've
interacted? Yes. In fact, I met the whole band personally because I was working for, I'm still working for a company which organized their last tour to the last continent and they performed in Antarctica.
Okay.
So I was lucky to be there for their cruise and I was cooking a special diet for the drummer, Lars.
Wow. Seriously?
All right, so you both are from Vasco. So what is it?
I'm from Konkolim. She is from Vasco.
You're originally from Vasco or something?
I was born in Vasco.
Yes.
Really?
So both of you are born in Vasco.
So since you all both are from the same place, have you all met before?
No, we've not.
Only on Facebook.
Only on Facebook. That's how we connected because he did a Kochro and someone tagged me and then I appreciated his song. And then he's like, oh, we should catch up sometime. And this is like totally a coincidence.
So this is like sheer coincidence.
On our show.
Seriously. Wow. Yeah.
Cecille, people all over Goa still remember you as a super mom. How does it feel?
It's been like 7 years ago, 2013 it was. An unexpected journey which I think so every person should, you know, open up their doors in their lives and take some really crazy steps and, you know, you never know where it may lead you. Like everyone thinks you do something for fame, but it's not for fame, it's for your self-satisfaction. And that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to, like, you know, make sure that I don't have any regret in life. So when I had the opportunity and it was the first season, I said, why not give it a shot? And from 2013 till now, if I go somewhere, people with the mask also recognize me, like Cecille. And I'm like, I've cut my hair. I have, yeah, but you know, it's like I've left an impression on them so much. It like, it just, it's
it overwhelming. It feels good, yeah, I know. Yeah, and I've followed those episodes religiously, like each and every episode, and I've seen your performance. You were outstanding. Seriously.
Yeah, because you know, I really didn't know what was happening back in Goa, because we didn't have any access to TV. We were just working 18 hours every day for 5 months. We were grilled. We had blood clots on our body. I have a metal plate in my back, and my back had given up. So I was 1.5 days grounded, bedridden. So I had to dance 2-3 episodes. I danced with a belt on my waistline, you know, to keep me strong, because we're doing somersaults and splits, and we still had to continue. So a lot of decisions which I have taken in life were risk, but with a good intention, saying that, you know, I want to work and do things in future, and nothing's stopping me from that day onwards. So I'm going ahead. Whatever comes my, I go with the flow. That's how life is, no? Whatever brings along, or however, whichever road I take, I just voice up and take action. So
that's why the roster.
Yeah, that's
take
why the roster.
Take any road you
take
want.
Take any road.
Khabir, you are into photography, cinematography, music, and a chef as well. What is your first love?
Actually, I was more fascinated with a camera before when I was a child. Cooking came to me later on. My uncle was a chef, so I seen him cooking things pretty fast, quickly, and he used to get it on the table, so I was more fascinated with that. So during that time, there was nobody to guide me properly, you know. So I feel my grandfather, I got this through him. Like, he was a very good photographer, an artist, a mechanic. By the way, he was an Austrian. So as I grew, when I finished my SSEN 12, then I said, okay, fine. I took a decision of being a chef. So I did my IHM in Purwoli, the FPP course, to be a chef at that time. So I didn't know at that time, like, I would end up being a chef. From there, I went to Taj Fort Aguada. From there, Renaissance. Then I was on the rigs for a while, and I got my job in Star Cruises during that time. It was the first batch from the Goans.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Which year was that?
I think in 2000. Since then, I'm working on vessels. Then after, in 2004 or something, I came up with my first album. I saw, like, okay, fine. Now, let me try my hands in music. Let me sing, because I used to play the guitar and I used to sing a couple of songs. And I used to always like to write my own songs and, you know, sing my own stuff. So no matter how bad it was, but it was mine.
Yeah, it's yours. Yeah, seriously.
It's mine. Yeah, so then I said, okay, let me get some couple of songs together and do an album. You know, during those times, the CDs were very popular. So I got in touch with Alan Fernandez. He recorded my first album in his home studio. And the first time when I saw him hitting a key on the keyboard, and there came a snare, there came a kick. So that's how then I started creating music.
So
by
now
myself.
You started creating your own music.
Yeah.
All right, so Cecille, tell us, when did you actually start dancing? You've been dancing quite some time. I mean,
School, we've been dancing. We had an all-girls dance group back in our school days. I think so we started dancing when we were in the 8th standard. And our parents, I think so our parents should be thanked so much, because they used to encourage us. That time we had CDs and we didn't have studios. We should like push away all the furnitures on the side. Yeah, and one wall used to be like the main way the audience would be. And then we would enter in and we would just like, you know, four girls trying to jam up. And we had all the same hairstyle, short hair with one shendi behind. We would wear the same clothes. And we were the first group. We used to perform for Alam Festival. You remember Alam Festival?
Yes.
So we were the only troupe that used to perform for Alam Festival.
What was the name?
Scorpions. So it was something, I mean, we will always cherish, and we all have like James Bond, like, but we were like four girls, Charlie's Angels.
I was just going to say
but
that.
Four, yeah. Four of us, where we clicked a picture together, like all of us in different sizes now. But yeah.
But you have maintained yourself so well. I mean, I know you since like 2000, and we had taken part for some DJ.
You know, we were there for a DJ course
yes,
together.
Yes, I remember she had gone. You also were there.
Yeah, and my father, Anki, they DJ, VJ, and all that. My
so, you all are both certified
Imagine
DJ.
Imagine if I had to get into
certified
DJ.
DJs.
You all are both certified DJs.
But we don't do that.
Yeah, we did a workshop, yeah, but I didn't pursue.
You can DJ for us tonight.
Yeah. She pursued it. Yeah. So,
yeah. Cecille, you should tell them what he used to do. That time he was in a dance group. Also, right?
No, actually,
very few people know that.
Aurvile and I, we were always on the rivalry side because they were reflexes, and then I joined a troupe called Moving Images with Savio and the team, and I was just getting to know more dancers from outside Vasco because I used to always dance in Vasco competition for college events and stuff. So when I joined a troupe here in Margao, Moving Images, that's when I started getting to know everyone.
Khabir, you have documentaries to your credit, which you made purely out of passion. Tell us something about this.
Not a certified documentary, sort of. It's like it's my hobby. If I see something bad, I just try and capture it and try to portray a message through it. So there's somebody who's taking care of it or sort of an awareness stuff. And mostly it's more related to garbage. First of all, cleanliness. Cleanliness is next to godliness. You cannot compare any other progress in a country or in a village or even in the house. It should start from there. Cleanliness is first. You're not going to build a new wardrobe or build a new table or build something else. You know, that's I'm just relating this to Goa or India or anywhere. So you won't do infrastructure development. You will start cleaning your area first, then to even think about any other development. So that's all depends on preference. And we are losing that. So I try to portray all these things, like especially garbage. I start from there. So a creative video with a good message, and it goes to people. And really, my videos sometimes really reach people. I made a video in Majorda. There was a small cross there, and it was really filthy with beer bottles and everything.
That's
I made a video, within 24 hours, it picked up about 15,000 views, and the very next morning, it was cleaned up by the same locals.
Wow.
So there is impact, same with your videos, you know, you make something like that, the next day somebody fixes it.
Yeah, fixes the roads,
Apart from these documentaries, you also do some other documentaries, I think, on your channel, some of these places that you visited and all those.
Yes, I do travel documentaries as well, so like if I like to travel also, and with my motorcycle, I've been to Kanyakumari and I've visited the biggest statue in the world now, which is built Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. So on the way, you come across some things very new to you that you were not aware of. And on the way, I came across a beautiful, vast area somewhere, I don't remember the state, but I saw windmills. And it was so beautiful. And I was speaking to the local there and they told me that these windmills generate so much of electricity for the locals there. So why these things can't be inculcated in Goa or places that we have so many beaches. Amko or dongra hai, yeah, hai tha kitu ware flow jata gala investing ko rai.
We as a state have a lot of resources.
We are a gold mine. We are living in a gold mine and we don't value it till it's lost. Then we'll be crying about it. So that's why, like, Khabir voices up his way, I voice up in our way, because we need people, small things, you know. No one likes to keep their surrounding dirty. No one likes to keep their compound dirty. But it's okay to throw it in someone else's backyard. It's okay to take a drink and just dump in the most beautiful places. And you're throwing bottles there.
It's as simple as this. It starts from a chocolate wrapper from your
kids.
They open the wrapper and they find it so normal to throw the wrapper out. It's normal because they've been taught by their parents. It's okay. Chalta hai.
Yeah, because parents are doing it.
If the parents start putting this wrapper in your pocket, the child will watch and still ask you, why are you putting that wrapper in your pocket? Then you should give a sensible answer to the child. Then they will follow you. Tomorrow they will eat a chocolate, they'll put it in the pocket and wait for a bin. That's it. I've noticed schools where their premises inside speak and span. The same children get out of the gates and throw the wrappers on the road.
Exactly.
So what is wrong here? The fear only that teachers and the school.
Or my mom will see the chocolate in my bag, so let me eat it
probably
now and just like throw it out. No, it's how it's everyone goes home to a different house, you know.
Yeah.
So we can't judge anyone what happens at home, but educating the children in the right way and having dustbins at distances is very important. So that, okay, fine, I know that 10 meters down the line, there's a dustbin. Yeah. And that's not happening anywhere. Panchayat, if you go to see, there's no dustbin, black spots everywhere. And one person has to start. Hari, someone's kept, like me also kept.
Yeah.
Yes. I think people fleeing out of the rivers. Kya kota tumi? This is what your, this is not your place where you reside. You're just throwing it out because you want to keep your house clean. What hypocrisy is this?
I've seen potholes on the trees. No fruits, but there are
garbage. I've seen shoes flung
plastic
on
bags
top.
Hanging there, yeah. Very true. I've seen this.
Even the side of highways,
Highways, it's like, are dustbin na chal udaiya. Kaun poina na, udaiya. See, panchayat and public have to work together. There has to be a coordination. So if public is saying, you know, please keep dustbin, make it easier for us, we will educate. But panchayat also not being responsive. Like say, when we do cleanliness drives, we tell the panchayat, see, we are doing this cleanliness drive, please have this garbage collected by evening. Others, you'll have animals come and collect it. 3 days, garbage is not being collected, and back to back, we went voicing up on this.
I can understand everybody is so frustrated with this, but nobody does voices out. But y'all are really doing a good job. Really, thank you, actually.
From day one of coronavirus, we've been out fearing, you know, we've had people say to us saying that, oh, she's going to get virus into the society. Every night we were going out, picking from hotel food, delivering it to people who don't have food. And no one understands the situation when there's, you say lockdown and there's no food supply.
Imagine
and food
those.
Is the most important. You might be the richest person or the poorest person.
Exactly.
Food is food, man. You just need dal and rice, or you just tandu kanji you can make. It's we've seen people cry, man. We've seen families cry till death. I get very emotional, but I thank God for keeping me safe wherever I've been. But we've seen shit. We've seen people suffer. We've seen people how they showed us their utensils and saying we don't have anything to eat. And God has blessed us with so much, and we waste. It's horrible. Okay, I think so. The situation that we are in, it's only when you go out from your comfort zone and you see the situation, it's when you really realize what's happening.
Really, people of Goa, we need to take this up seriously. We need to be really serious about this, because people like Cecille and Khabir, like, they're voicing it out. They're doing everything they can to keep us safe, to keep people well fed and all, and still we act like as if
nothing is happening.
So please let's help Goa get better.
See, it's everybody's responsibility.
Each one.
Likes somebody throwing garbage on the road or anywhere in the fields, anywhere. They see it, they watch them do, but what they will say,
that's it, yeah,
and they will carry on with their life. How about stop? Ask that person, Baba, tu kitko ta? Okay, be polite. You don't need to go and be aggressive. At least stop and ask. That's all we want. Imagine 10, 20 people stopping and asking the same stupid guy who is throwing this. He might realize, Are, every time I throw, there is somebody who is looking at me. Mak laws, bestie. They're questioning me.
Fear.
So maybe I will stop doing it.
Being women, it's easy to throw a pad out in the open, saying that someone will collect it. That someone is collecting it. I have collected used pads, soggy, with period stains, and put into dustbins.
Same thing, even in my experience, 60% of the garbage which is thrown on the roads are sanitary pads and Pampers. If you can come all the way from your house with your bike or car and throw it in the fields, you can might as well take the same shit and put it in the bin as like what I said, this is more important than any other development.
Cecille, you're into professional dancing, Zumba, activism, you've even got into politics, acting, modeling, whatever, you name it, and you've done it. How do you make time at home?
Luckily, all these things have its time, you know. So if I'm doing social activism, I have my time and I go out and then I'm back home. If I'm doing dancing, then I work for those hours. So it's all balanced. Yeah, I make time because, as I said earlier also, if you don't contribute to our Goa, it's gone. And I love Goa so much, and Goa has given me so much. Even on the DID platform, Goa supported me to reach where I am. And least I can do is contribute towards Goa as to what it's given me. And if I can motivate even two more people, I think so, I'm doing a good deed. But I try and I balance it. So I'm a very balanced person mentally. So I even something hits me very bad, I take it in a good spirit. Even when I got arrested because of the field work. So I was like fighting till the end, till I was taken inside. You don't dare touch me. You tell me the reason why you're taking me. I have not hit anyone. I have not slept anyone. I have not fired anyone. I just sat beside the road. I didn't sit in between the road. And you just grab me and you take me. I'm what, roadside property, that garbage is just being collected and being dumped inside.
What is to be collected is not collected.
Yeah, yet. So it's you fight. You have to fight up and you do what you have to do. You know, everyone says, take care, Cecille. Everyone's saying, take care, be safe. But no one is coming out and saying, okay, it's my responsibility too. I live in Goa. I'm a Goinkar. What is Goinkar? What is Goinkar porn? It's like we using our art form to voice up as much as we can. You know, I didn't even think 10 years down the line I would be doing this, what I'm doing today.
Khabir, you have also taken up a lot of social causes. Anything that inspired you or what made you?
Like recently on Facebook, you did this thing of giving food to the...
Recently, I think.
Just happened to...
What happened is when I came, I was also stuck on board due to the this pandemic and lockdown and stuff. Now, since everything is in lockdown, people have lost their jobs. I'm talking about daily wage workers or a person in a, you know, Garib Garabo, where the person is working in a hotel for 3,000, 5,000, 6,000 rupees per month, you know, and only one bread earner for a family of four. And these kind of people are out of job and it's really, really difficult for them to survive.
Very true.
So I thought about these people and I made a post. So I put up a post saying that like I'm organizing this kind of groceries and me and my family and relatives are contributing for this. And if anybody else wishes to contribute, that they trust me, they can please. And I gave my bank account number as well as Google Pay. And you won't believe, within 2 days, I received a lot of response. People started calling me, saying that, okay, this is the amount I'm giving you, please don't mention my name. We trust you and we know that this food is going to go to the right person, deserving people. So I was so, so happy with the response. I had to make a post saying that, please stop sending me funds, enough. Okay, let me utilize this funds and give it to the person. So I took off my post and everything. And then as I started distributing, I started on 13th July, I started with 5 families. Then I did 15 and then 10, like this, I cleared now 60 families.
Wow.
And I went and gave it to them personally.
Proud of you.
Personally, yeah, checking. Because, and I really, same like you, you was in tears. I saw their living conditions.
It's horrible.
I saw their living conditions. And that is why I was so happy that we were able... Collectively, we were able to help these people. And I could see it in their eyes. They were in tears saying that this, what you gave us is lots. I have helped you
people
guys.
People have come together.
People have come together. I am just a channel.
Logistics. You're doing the logistics.
I'm giving you this.
I'm Kamdar.
And you don't need to even tell who has given you and like that.
And sometimes the migrants tell you, you know, don't give us excess because... If they store more, then they have a rat problem.
Yes,
rat come
yes,
and
exactly.
eat their food. So there, so many people have told us, you know, just this is enough. This is what we
actually,
need.
Yeah,
don't give us anything more. Because if we need more, we will tell you. So they used to come back to us after a week and say, we are running out. Please, if you can, provide us. Because this is the problem that they've been facing.
And with the, that's not done. Then I had still more funds. And I gave 5 PPE kits for the Bali Health Center.
Yeah, you know, if people come together... Nothing is impossible. Yeah. It's a shout out that he's given out, yeah, which is amazing.
Not me.
Your video.
I was just a channel. This was very
hats
nice.
Off. I'm so inspired right now by both of you. So much
thank you.
Positivity also around and really feeling great at the moment.
Cecille, you are successful in all fields. Acting, dancing, singing. All fields are successful. Even the paddy field.
Oh, yeah. That's a star. That's a baby star.
So, how do you... What is it? It's you have any plans for the future? I mean, it's nice. You're motivating youngsters who to come into the field.
That's very important, actually.
I'll tell you how that got me motivated is because of our land feeling which happened in Taligaon. Where the farmers' field Even after plowing their fields, debris and garbage was dumped into their fields. Imagine you have done up your field. And plowing, trust me, is not an easy job when you have the bullock carts going through, or even you pay money for the tractor to come in and do the job. And you have debris being dumped just overnight, all of a sudden. And then the farmers contacted the local people, and then everyone started calling each other that tomorrow we are meeting at so-and-so timing. Said, okay, we'll all come. That's how it all started, where everyone came in to help these 8 farmers. That was the starting step which motivated, saying that, you know, this is not right and we have to fight for our farmers. With that happened, Father Lawrence from Don Bosco, Orchel, he decided to have, like, you know, helping farmers out who needed help. Like, you know, sometimes people didn't have money to get volunteers to do, like, you know, the rice plowing. When you put the grains, the rice saplings are taken out and then it's transplanted. I didn't know hair or tail about it.
We don't know.
Yeah, and I, being in Taligaon, suddenly I came to know Father's doing it here in Nuven and in Raya. We said, hey, how about we introduce something like this in Taligaon, but let's go to learn. So we came to Raya, we came to Nuven, we removed the rice saplings out, we went to Raya, we planted it. It was a whole day and we had the sheath kodi, we had the salt fish, with, like, you know, and we ate in the fields. It was such an amazing day. It's like a picnic with work, learning something. I mean, we've forgotten what is picnic. It's like not throwing trash and just having fun, but doing productive way. And it was an amazing... We got our backs broke. We got burnt like mad. Children started throwing mud on each other. We had mud on our body. So it was like, mud wall. It should take out mud and start throwing. So I'm telling you, that one thing that we started off, we said, shit, we've got to do more. And we started helping. I've volunteered 4 days of my time to be with the farmers and to talk to them, to understand them, and to see this amazing 60-year-old and 70-year-old. What energy! Taba, 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 taba. And all of them, 16 of them in line and back to back. They are like coordinated in sync. You don't need machinery also. It's
exactly,
like,
exactly.
They're full on, you know. But if we need to cultivate more, we need fundings. Fundings is give more technology where you have the rice saplings lifted up and automatically planted. That's where we need to start getting the open bare fields where children come forward, like college students, students that got a subject of agriculture. Put it, have practical. Why you need only a practical of cutting a frog or cutting something else
exactly.
there? The system should be practical and where you enjoy the fruit. Or you enjoy the vegetables, where whatever you sell, they become young producers, you know, you sell your product. Whatever you earn, you give the landowner if he's not doing anything with his field.
So what's the way forward now?
It's people coming together. You see a bare land, find out whose land it is, meet up with the landowner, saying that can we support
cultivate
you
or it.
Can we do it for you? Like, you know, and sharing basis, like whatever we sell or what we produce, we'll share 50-50 or whatever the percentage the landowner wants to decide. But get that land. We are in a gold mine. You don't need gold. Food is gold.
Okay, it was really lovely talking to you, but we want you to give one message to our viewers.
All I would like to tell the people of Goa is this is the time that we need to come out. We need to be each other's support. We need to help one another. And we need to understand the present situation and take this forward, because today Goa is facing a very, very hard situation where you can see Goa getting destroyed every second. And if we, the true Goenkas, don't step forward, or people residing in Goa don't step forward, it is going to be finished. So my humble request to everyone, come together, because every knowledge is important in taking Goa forward in a better way. And our voices need to be heard now. We need to be the change. We need to make the change now. Others in 2020, if we don't realize, it's going to be too late and Goa is going to be finished. I love you guys and I want you to be active for our beautiful Goa.
God has gifted us with so much of talent. The whole world knows Goenkas. We are a part of India, yes, but we have a special gift given to us. It's an identity and we have to keep it. We have to keep it that way. And the only way it will happen is if we are together, united, united as one. Ata differentiation, korpa chana, religion or caste or creed or whatever difference differences we have ye maashe bagangalai zip korai ane lock marai and especially the youth of Goa come up and do something for Goa because you are the future. That is all I'm saying. Youth, take over Goa. This is the only chance you have, otherwise we are finished.
Well, Khabir, that was really a deep message and really very nice message. So with that,
let's get a little lighter. Let's be a game. Okay. Game? And for this game, we require, first of all, to stand.
Yes,
so let's all stand. Okay. So, you're a chef anyways.
Yeah.
This game is about cooking. You're good at cooking, right?
I'll survive. If you say I'll survive.
All right. Okay, what do you guys want to cook?
Something Goan? Yeah?
Yeah, of course.
You like kafriel?
I love kafriel.
Okay. Kafriel. Right. Chicken kafriel.
So chicken
okay,
kafriel?
Chicken kafriel. Oh, yes.
Okay, so come you on. Guys are going to be cooking chicken kafriel.
Okay.
There's a catch. As you are cooking, like, say for example, Khabir starts. Whatever he says, you have to continue in a different language.
Different language?
We will tell you the language. We will tell you when to switch. The remote is in our hand. Are we good to go?
Okay. You'll know all the languages.
Okay, let's start with Khabir.
All right.
Okay. Go from scratch.
Scratch.
Okay. In Konkani. Start.
I'm going to put a chicken here. Bazana san chicken area. এই চিকন আমি মিডিয়াম সাইজ ইন কাতুর পাচে আর এক বোলাঙ্গানতুর পাচে
হিন্দি
উসকে বাদ হরি ধনিয়া লেনে কা থোড়া হরি মির্চ থোড়া অদরক থোড়া লসুন
ইংলিশ
দেন টেক সাম ভিনেগার সাম কিউমিন সাম সিনামন সাম ক্লোভস
কংকনি
তে সগলে আমি মিক্স করপাচে আ তো আদড়িচে
আড়ে
হাতরাচে হাতরাচে আড়েন মাটপাচে আর তো মিক্সচার কেপাচ আনি বরে কোন তেঙ্কা চিকেন লাপাচে আনি ম্যারিনেট করপাচে
পজ সেসিল কন্টিনিউ ফ্রম দে
ওকে ম্যারিনেশন পার্ট ওকে 24 আওয়ার্স
কংকনি
24 ওকে 24 hora marination marination is the mixture fridge in dorpache ani magir upran sagle item hate bahar kadpak jay ani ek oldi si andi gyopak jay tel galpak jay
andi
tel dalne ka aur fir वो उबालने का है वो तेल और फिर बाद में डायरेक्टली चिकन को अंदर फेंकने का है डालने का है और फिर जब वो बॉयल होता व्हाट यू कॉल दैट
उबलने लगता
पकता,
नहीं नहीं पकता है जब वो पकता है तो फिर उसको टॉस करने का है ओके सो ये करने के बाद थोड़ा देर
इंग्लिश
ओके यू हैव टू कीप दैट चिकन फॉर सम टाइम हीटेड ऑन टू द पैन फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम Because the more the oil is hot and the more it...
Khabir, Konkani.
Magite. Magite, chicken zapa hai te timer tu check kar pa jaye tege isko atlan. Bre soft ha jale. मागी ते सारे तुगे कूक कर पाजे अंडी घन कूक पाजे ते जोलेन कित्यार मॉइश्चर ते मशे सॉफ्ट जाता चिकन मागीर ते काड जाता चिकन काड आनी प्लेटीर घाल बरे भाशेन आनी थोडे फ्रायड पोटेटोज आनी कांदो
आनी
थोडा हरी हरी धनिया से उसको गार्निश करने अरे बाद में खाने का
Okay, well played,
guys.
Yeah,
well played. It this thing just shows like however good a chef you are, but you still get stuck when you try to explain it in different languages or you try to put it in words.
Yes, yes, yes.
But when you're doing it, you, I don't think there are gaps, no.
You made us go virtual. First of all, when I'm in the kitchen, only I struggle and virtual.
That's even difficult, right?
Yeah.
Well, good. 100 points to him.
Yeah. So, who do you think won?
Obviously, what? Who do you think?
So we are all invited there for yes. Yeah, that's a to job. Have that cocktail, but this time not virtual. We won't have virtual. You make service
the,
virtual.
The real one. The real
yes, yes, yes. Don't worry. I will make a special menu for you guys.
So it is really nice having you both here. Yeah,
thank you.
Thank you for coming. Thank you.
We had fun. Yeah.
Thank you for inviting us. As
And we are going to leave our viewers with Khabir's song right now.
But before that, a little token of our appreciation.
Yes. And we have Melanie coming with it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Please.
Hit the stage.
Thank you.
Yeah. Come on.
Khabir, ladies and gentlemen.
Chirap house sota hanga tanga wasan picnic yo kotat bore tight zaun dado shi zatat boro bus marun nitum chi zatot koto kor kya zager tumi sota hey tu kire kotai gara kore kelolo kotro huyuroitai hey tu kalozi de sona Tule potle korun rastyar turtai Bazaran waitai hami hat halowun Bajigetat barik topasun Makityo sokulyo potlet galun Poteyetat tumi rastyar uro Ata tumi beste moje aikat Bazarante saman tumi harun Aple aple pega hatche galun Potyo pishi odi yaktyo sorun Hey, tum kire kotai Gara kore kelolo kotro hui uroitai Hey, tuka lozi di sona Takule potle korun rastyar turoitai Takite korche tumi moje aikat sansar bodola ami tumi sorot asat iskolan hami tisiksha diuji somazan sudar pandurgi ache soche politics tumi siknarak diuche crime field leaders tumi niudun hadche sababdari hamchi padun keuche na to tuzo phone kadun tatu tumi nitche hey tu ki dekhotai Gara kore kelolo kotro hui uroitai Hey, tuka lozi di sona Takule potle korun rastyar turoitai Gara kore kelolo kotro hui uroitai
Superb. That was a superb song.
That was an awesome performance, Khabir.
Superb.
Thank you so much.
And a lovely message in that song, really. And Cecille, your dance was outstanding.
Nice to see you after a long time back dancing.
I know, and that was a one take shoot.
One take shoot, yes, exactly.
It just happened all of a sudden, and to the cameraman, Brendan and Jojo and the team, fabulous guys. I think so we pushed each other to take a one take shoot, and
superb.
Amazing concept and the energy in the whole interview and everything that, and I bet Khabir, I never knew that he would do something with Kochro, Rosto, and we would team up again, you know, on a show like this. And I think so we'll be doing work ahead together. So looking forward to that. And thank you guys for organizing something. And guys who's watching, please like, subscribe and do whatever you can to reach out this message to whoever you can. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you very much. I would also like to give a small message to the youth. Please. Take this into our hands and let us take our Goa to the right place. Thank you so much, everybody.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, with this, we come to that part where we say adios. We don't like doing it, but we have to. Thank you for being with us.
Well, this is Silvia and Aurvile, along with Cecille and Khabir and the entire team of the Warehouse Studio saying,
We'll be back!